Welcome. In this module, we will use the program R to analyze the mean change in HbA1c following FSL initiation in the Hull data. For this analysis, we will have to download the data from the ABCD FSL audit website, which is available here. This has been previously demonstrated in a separate module. Once the data has downloaded, you will have to download a R script, which will also be available on the ABCD website. For this analysis, I have downloaded the data in a folder called as FSL data, and it is kept on my desktop. You can see there are two files, the file.csv. It is the output file which has been downloaded from the audit website. You can also see the FSL code hba1c analysis.txt, which is the R code downloaded from the ABCD website. Now we move on to the analysis. So let's start by opening the script. The first step is to download and install R. The link to install R is given in the second line. This is the home page for the R software. It is an open source free program and should be downloaded and can be downloaded on most of the computers. Once the R is downloaded, you should be able to see an icon on your computer named as R. You can also access it through your programs menu. If I double click on R, the R console opens up. This is how the R console looks. The next step in analysis is telling the R software where the data is stored. So I go to my folder and highlight the path of the data and copy it. Once this is copied, I go back to R and I give the command set working directory, which is set wd, and I paste the path. Because R does not like backward slashes, we have to change these to forward slashes. And then we press enter, and this is we telling R where the data is stored. Now we go back to our R script again, and then we type the command source and the name of the script which we have downloaded from the ABCD website. So I copy and I paste. This command should have created three files in the same folder. So as you can see, there is a JPG and two text files. So let us look at the JPG file first. This file gives you a box plot of median pre and post FSL HbA1c. You can see that the pre FSL HbA1c is higher than the post FSL HbA1c, and there are notches in the box plot indicating that this difference is statistically significant. Next, we looked at the t-test from the analysis. The second file t-test.txt gives this analysis. You can see the mean of the post FSL HbA1c, which is 69.12, and the mean of the post FSL HbA1c, which is 61. The p-value from this test can be found here, and as you can see, it is statistically significant. If the data are small, it is possible that the HbA1c are not normally distributed. In that case, we recommend that you use a non-parametric test. The results of the non-parametric test can be seen in the next file, which is Wilcox.test. This gives p-value from a Mann-Whitney-U or Wilcox test. As you can see, the p-value here is also statistically significant. R code will be available for analysis of HbA1c cold score, diabetes distress score, hospital admissions, and other parameters in the FSL audit. This can be downloaded and run by following the instructions in this code. So this is how we use R code to analyze the FSL HbA1c data. Thank you.